in the county Tyrone, near the town of Dungannon, where many's eruption myself had a hannin'. Bob Williamson lived, however betrayed, and all of us thought him a stout orange blade. On the 12th of July, as it yearly did come, Bob played with his flute to the sound of a drum. He may talk of your harp, your piano, or lute, but there's none could compare with the old orange flute. But Bob the deceiver, he took us all in. He married a papist called Bridget McGinn, turned papish himself and forsook the old cause that gave us our freedom, religion and laws. Now the boys of the place made some comment upon it, and Bob had to fly to the province of Connaught. He fled with his wife and his fixings to boot, and along with the latter his old orange flute. At the chapel on Sunday to atone for past deeds, said pathers and alleys and counted his beads, till after some time at the priest's own desire, he went with the old flute to play in the choir. He went with the old flute to play for the mass, but the instrument shivered and sighed, oh alas. And try though he would, though it made a great noise, the flute would play only the Protestant boys. Bob jumped and he started and got in a flutter, and threw the old flute in the blessed holy water. He thought that this charm would bring some other sound, when he tried it again it played crappies lie down. And for all he would whistle and finger and blow, to play papish music he found it no go. Kick the Pope and wine water it freely would sound, but one papish squeaking it couldn't be found. At the council of priests that was held the next day, they decided to banish the old flute away. They couldn't knock heresy out of its head, so they bought Bob a new one to play in its stead. Well, the old flute was doomed, and its fate was pathetic. 'Twas fastened and burned at the stake as heretic. As the flames soared around it, they heard a strange noise, as the old flute still whistling the Protestant boys. Torally, torally, oh, it's 6 miles from Bangor to Donaghadee.